guys, welcome to today's video on how my friend Chakradhar got into Oracle as an associate software engineer. So without further ado, let's get started. So hi Chakradhar, how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm fine, Atul.
Okay, great, great, awesome. Nice to see you after so many months, I would say.
Yeah.
Okay. So you are at your home?
Yeah, I'm at my home.
Okay, so it's work from home going on right now.
Yes.
Okay. Awesome. So, you know, today we'll kind of just share with the audience about your journey on getting into Oracle with a few questions so that they get an idea of this entire process. Okay, so maybe if you can just introduce yourself to the audience once that we get.
So, I'm in same year as Atul. Yeah. And I'm an information technology student. We studied in same class in first year.
Yeah. Correct. Yeah. So now, you know, jumping to the main agenda or story for today about is Oracle. So first question that comes to the mind is, you know, how did you know about Oracle?
Like every computer science, every computer science students knows about database, like Oracle database.
Okay.
And I have worked with Oracle database and.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a fan of Larry Ellison, the CEO of company. He is fifth richest man in the world.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. So yeah, I mean, what you mean to say is most of the computer science students will be already knowing that Oracle is something that they aspire to get into once they graduate.
Yeah, we have it in our syllabus too.
Okay, great.
In database.
Awesome. So the journey starts from the roots of the syllabus itself also.
Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. And, you know, for many new people out there, maybe if you can just summarize quickly, what is it exactly that Oracle does in terms of their work?
Yeah, Oracle is mainly known for its software products like database, NetSuite, etc.
Okay.
And also it owns Java also.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So it provides many B2B services, that means business to business services.
Okay.
Like NetSuite is a ERP service provider.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. And it has acquired many companies over the
year. Correct.
Like Cerner, NetSuite, etc.
Correct.
And we manage that.
Okay. Awesome. So for all those of you who, you know, want to get into cloud related roles or ERP or software engineering, I think this is one of the great companies to get into, right?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, absolutely. And now, you know, now let's move on to the job requirements, because many people have this in mind that, you know, hey, what are the requirements? Is there a minimum CGPA or are there just a couple of branches through which, which are eligible to apply? So maybe if you can just clear that stuff up for us.
Yes, minimum CGPA requirement for our university is 7.
Yeah.
So if you have 7 GPA, you are eligible to apply for the company.
Okay.
One of my friend with 7.2 GPA also got the job.
Okay.
So if you have just minimum CGPA, you are good to go.
Okay.
And when it comes to branches, most of the branches, computer and electrical branches are
eligible for.
Yeah, eligible for.
Okay. Awesome. So, right. So all of you who kind of don't have a great CGP and all, you don't need to worry. If you're good at software, you'll get into this company. So good news for you guys. And, you know, so yeah, now coming to you, what offer have you secured and what is your role like in the company in this internship maybe?
So I have secured offer through campus placements. It is P plus I offer. That means placement plus internship offer.
Right.
So right now I'm doing internship, and after the internship I'll be starting the full-time job. My role is associate software engineer, so I'll be working in software development and also testing in both the parts.
Okay. Awesome. Yes. Cool. And so now that we have understood the role and the requirements, now let's get into the main process of the bulk of this interview, which is the application process, the main thing. which many people want to hear about. So, you know, what was the application process like, you know, in terms of how many rounds of interviews, and if there was an MCQ or some test, what kind of questions are asked generally? So if you can highlight maybe the important parts of the application process.
So there are basically 5 rounds in the interview. First okay. round is MCQs.
Okay.
So MCQs are normally based on math, English and coding.
Okay.
So there are few basic math questions, normally NCERT level
okay.
Math uh-huh. questions. And okay. then most of the coding questions are based on trees. Mostly okay. they ask questions based on AVL trees.
Okay.
And even stacks. Like
okay.
pushing and popping out of the stacks.
Okay.
And then English is like basic English questions.
Okay.
Like filling the missing words or mm-hmm. something like that.
Right. Got it.
So that's the first round. Second mm-hmm. round was coding round. So
okay.
there was basically two questions in the coding round.
Okay.
First question was basically normal matrices.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And second question was on graph, mainly on Dijkstra's okay. algorithm.
Mm-hmm.
So that was second round. It was an online coding test.
Okay. I know. Okay.
And wow. then coming to next 3 rounds were held on the same day. They both are
okay.
Face-to-face interview.
Okay.
And out of the 3, the first interview was a normal coding interview
uh-huh.
based on data structures and algorithms.
Okay.
I was asked 2 questions and
okay.
Both of them were on trees.
Acha, so I think DSA is like very important.
Yeah, very important.
Correct,
in
correct.
Application right. process.
Cool, cool. Okay. Right.
Yeah. And coming to the next round, the second interview of on that day was basically a mix of managerial and coding. So
okay.
I was asked few sorting algorithm
uh-huh.
Questions, and then it was based on my CV.
Okay.
So and my projects, detailed explanation of my project.
Okay. Got it.
Yeah. And even the last interview was mostly on managerial and HR.
Okay.
So again on my CV and HR, basic HR questions.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah,
so
then
5 interviews in total.
Yeah. The next day I was I got the offer.
Okay.
2 rounds are on separate days.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And the next 3 rounds are on the same day.
Okay, I see. So it's a process of 2-3 days around.
Yeah, it is exactly 3 days process.
3 days process. Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. So, and coming to your office location, like right now it will be work from home, but like, are you guys assigned a specific location or do
yeah.
you have options to select from?
Yeah, we don't have any options to select from. It is in Bangalore. In
okay.
Bellandur Road.
Okay.
It is a new office.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. So you'll be hopefully going back to Bangalore now once the lockdown ends.
Yeah.
So, cool. Okay. And you know, now let's jump on to some FAQs which generally kind of people have in mind. So I've just kind of listed some based on my conversation with friends and juniors. So you know, first question which comes to the mind is, how did you develop interest in this field of software engineering? Like reflecting back on childhood or maybe in the past 5-6 years, how did you develop this interest into software?
I always had interest in making websites and apps. I always wanted to make an app or website.
Okay.
So in first year, I learned web development through mm-hmm. Mix of YouTube tutorials and Udemy courses.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then I joined a club in my college called IECSC.
Okay.
There right. I got more exposure to web development and I worked on many websites.
Correct.
And I made games for Fest.
Okay.
So that's how I got interest
awesome.
In this field.
Awesome. Cool. I think most of the coders kind of have this similar passion which they share.
Yeah.
How their interest was built. Cool. Awesome. And you know, now coming to the course structure and what we were taught during our BTech subjects, do you think there are specific subjects in information technology course that we studied in Manipal specifically that you think were helpful for your job or process of applying?
Yes, the most important subject is obviously DSA.
Okay. Right.
Yeah, data structures and algorithms are correct. Most asked in any interview.
Correct,
and
absolutely.
In Oracle, it is like most tasks, and databases were also like really helpful.
Mm-hmm.
And the projects we did in the labs were also helpful during the interviews.
Okay, I see.
Yeah.
Right. Cool. Great. So I'll just I'll maybe highlight all these things, the main topics and things that you need to focus on. Now comes a bit of a different question, which is, you know, for someone who is new into coding, how and from where can he practice? And, you know, like I'll also give your YouTube link here so that they can even watch. I think you have kind of summarized it, but maybe just to recap, if you can tell about how people who are new into coding can, you know, develop themselves.
Yeah, first thing is you need to, like, you have various resources in YouTube. One channel I recommend is Free Code Camp. There are many coding tutorials in it.
Mm-hmm.
And there is also Free Code Camp website.
Mm-hmm.
There are tons of coding tutorials in it.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I also recommend courses in Udemy, especially ZTM, Zero to Mastery courses by Andrew Nygoy.
Mm-hmm.
They are really excellent.
Mm-hmm.
I learned web development and Python from his courses.
Okay, I see.
They're really helpful. You can check them out.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Awesome. So what I'll do, guys, is I'll add the links of all these in the description. And so now we come on to the last question, which is, you know, any specific tips and advice that you have for prospective applicants to maybe any software engineering company. So if you can just give any tips and suggestions from your side based on your experience.
Yeah, my first tip would be do proper research when you are learning any new topic or when you are appearing for an interview for a particular company.
Mm-hmm.
You need to know, like, which topics they normally ask. Like,
mm-hmm.
for example, or for any particular X company, it asks mostly on operating systems, and you prepare mostly on computer networks, then it will not be like proper preparation. So do your research. That's my first tip. And my another tip will be, like, in interviews, if you don't know a particular topic,
mm-hmm.
like, it's better to say that you don't know or you'll read up on it than giving a wrong answer,
right?
Because it gives negative impression.
Correct. Correct.
That's my important tip.
Okay. Awesome. Cool. So I think we are at the end of this small session, and thanks a lot, Chakradhar, for your time. And I think this video will be really helpful for people who want to apply to software engineering roles, and specifically to Oracle. And hopefully, and if there are any questions you guys have, feel free to put it in the comment section, and both of us will try to get back to you as soon as possible. So thanks for watching. Also, do subscribe to Chakradhar's channel called Tech Chuck. I'll add to, and to my channel as well. Okay.
Yes.
So hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Losing time, I'm fading fast. I just wanna make it last. Try to let go of the past. I close my eyes, embrace the blast. Sleepless nights and headache stack. Restlessness to hell and back. What's my purpose? What do I grab? A slippery surface, a heart attack.